Hi everyone, Michael here with Behringer, and today I wanted to discuss routing FX to your monitor mix outputs, aka your AUX outputs. I still get people readily asking us how this is possible, so I wanted to take a moment to help demonstrate how easy it is to do this using your X-Air mixer. I'm going to be demonstrating this process by sending my voice via channel input number 1 to the built-in vintage reverb effect on X-Air using FX Bus 1. And then feeding a blend of both voice and effect to the AUX 1 output. So as you can see in here, I've already got my voice coming in on channel 1 right here. And this is being sent to the AUX 1 output. So what you're hearing right now in this video is me actually recording the AUX 1 output. So let's go back to the main mix window. So first, let's feed my voice to the vintage reverb effect using the FX1 bus. To do that, you just go over to the FX1 bus tab here on the right-hand side of the screen, and click it. And now we're sending on faders to that effect. So you just go over to your channel 1 input, raise the fader, and now we are feeding my voice to the vintage reverb effect in FX1 on X-Air. And you can see that right here in the main mix window. FX1 is where my voice is coming in. Now also remember, you're not going to hear the effect just yet, because while we've sent my voice to effect number 1, we haven't actually sent it anywhere else. So seeing as my voice is getting to the vintage reverb, we can now take the return of that signal and feed it to my AUX 1 output. To do this, select the Bus 1 tab on the right hand side of the screen, as this is where your monitor mix would be. And then just go ahead and raise the fader for the FX1 vintage reverb. As I do this slowly, you'll notice that the reverb starts to come in on my vocal. So now you're getting a blend of voice and the reverb mixed together on the AUX1 output. And that's it. So I'm just going to go ahead and mute that for the time being. It's important to mention that you will have to have the input channel volume faders turned up in order to properly feed your FX buses. Otherwise, the steps I outlined above will not work as you would expect. Just as an example, when I bring the channel 1 fader volume down, you'll notice that the signal slowly decreases from my FX1 send. So I'm talking, and now you're not seeing anything here in FX1. So make sure that you have your main left-right volume faders turned up for your input channel, otherwise this will not work properly. Also keep in mind that if you are using an insert effect instead of an FX bus send and return, then you can avoid all of this completely. And the reason for this is because when an FX gets inserted on an input channel, it then becomes one with that channel's audio signal path. So anywhere you send that input channel, the inserted effect will also be present. So that's how easy it is to feed FX to your AUX bus outputs on X-Air mixers. Please feel free to share this video and or leave a reply message in the comments below. Of course, if you have ideas for other X-Air quick tip videos you'd like to see in the future, please let us know. Thanks guys, and we'll see you next time.